In this video, I will be formulating and solving this LP problem. Blending problems in linear programming involves mixing different ingredients to produce one or more products. The goal typically is to determine the amount of ingredients or raw materials to include in the final products, with the objective of either maximizing profit or minimizing cost. In this hypothetical scenario, the ingredients are the three processed crudes, and the products are the two gasoline types, regular and premium. The objective is to maximize profit. A nice way to set up the decision variables is to create a table like this one. We can let R1 be the amount, that is, number of barrels of crude 1 in regular gasoline. Likewise, R2 will be crude 2 in regular, and R3 will be crude 3 in regular. Similarly, for premium, we have P1, P2, and P3. Equivalently, we could write RI equals barrels of crude R in regular, and PI equals barrels of crude R in premium, where R equals 1, 2, and 3. Now, the objective is to maximize profit, which we will obtain by subtracting the costs from the selling prices. We have 160 selling price for regular and 180 for premium per barrel. The costs are 120, 109, and 98 respectively for the crudes. The profit realized from each barrel of crude 1 in regular sold is therefore 160 minus 120, which gives 40. For crude 1 in premium, it is 180 minus 120, which gives 60. Similarly, we have 51 for R2, 71 for P2, 62 for R3, and 82 for P3. The objective function can thus be presented as follows. Now, for the constraints, we can start with the available supply of the crudes. For crude 1, we write R1 plus P1 less than or equal to 82,000. Less or equals because we cannot use more than available supply. We do the same for crude 2 and for crude 3. Now we're provided with the octane rating for the crudes, but the octane ratings for the products are constrained by these given minimum values. For the octane constraint for regular, we can write 95 R1 plus 89 R2 plus 85 R3 greater or equal to 88 times R1 plus R2 plus R3. Recall that R1 is essentially crude 1 but contained in regular, and crude 1 has an octane rating of 95. Therefore, 95 R1 is the total octane contribution of crude 1 to regular. Similarly, 89 R2 for crude 2 and 85 R3 for crude 3. Minimum 88 here means at least 88, so we use the greater or equal sign. Then 88 times regular. Note that regular means R1 plus R2 plus R3. Rewriting it so that there are no variables on the right-hand side gives 7R1 plus R2 minus 3R3 greater or equal to 0. For premium, the octane rating should be minimum 91. So again, the coefficients on the left are the octane ratings for the crudes. Minimum 91 means at least 91 or greater or equal to 91 times the total amount of premium. That can also be rewritten as 4P1 minus 2P2 minus 6P3 greater or equal to 0. Next, we examine these product requirements. At most, 30% crude 1 in regular implies crude 1 in regular should be no more than 30% of regular. And that can be rewritten with constants on the right here for software solution purposes. At least 25% crude 3 in regular can be written similarly with greater or equal sign. And that is rewritten as follows. Now to premium. Minimum 20% crude 1 means that crude 1 in premium should be at least 20% of premium. We can rewrite that as seen here. No more than 35% crude 2 can also be written as P2 less than or equal to 0.35 times premium. That can also be rewritten as seen here. For the last premium constraint, crude 1 should exceed crude 3 by no less than 50,000 barrels. This means that crude 1 in premium should be at least 50,000 barrels more than crude 3 in premium. We can then bring P3 to the left to have no variable on the right side. Finally, adding the non-negativity constraints, we have the complete LP model here. To solve it, I'm going to paste it in this LP software called Lindo. You will find the link to my video on how to install Lindo and use it to solve LP models in description. I'm going to click Solve. And here is the solution. Thanks for watching.